This is the final part of this lecture on updated field version, Humphrey versus OCTOPUS. Now we come to defect patterns. These are different examples of defect patterns. Can be centrocaecal, can be no fiber defect, can be centroscotoma, can be hemianopia, can be quadranopia. Can be heteronymous hemianopia. What about glaucoma? The defects pattern of glaucoma can be in the form of generalized depression, paracentral scotoma, nasal step, arcuate or Bjerrum scotoma, altitudinal defect, and lastly, temporal wedge. Generalized depression can occur early stages of glaucoma, but it is rare in the absence of associated local defects. Keep in mind that there are other causes for generalized depression of the field, like media opacity, like meiotic pupil, or uncorrected error refraction while doing the field of the vision test. This is an example of generalized depression where you see changes here and nothing is seen in the pattern deviation. Also, if you check the mean deviation, here it is minus 14, so this is severe generalized depression. And notice also here the fovea threshold is reduced. Normally it is in the 30-32, but here it is 19. Second is paracentral scotoma. Defects in this area inside the central 10 degrees, but outside the central 5 degrees. So if you have a defect in the central 5 degrees, this is centroscotoma. Paracentral means it is outside the central 5 and it is within the central 10. As you notice here, the new software of Humphrey included these points, paracentral area, that is commonly seen in cases of early stages of glaucoma. Third, we have the nasal step. You can diagnose nasal step if you have changes in the one of the hemispheres and not similar changes in the opposite lower hemisphere. As in this example, also you can see it here in this example. Again, something here on the nasal area, nothing in front on the opposite hemisphere. Arcuate scotoma, it's a defect between 10 to 20 degrees. It extends from the optic disc, it's arcuate, and it ends respecting the horizontal line. It can be starting, like here, a sidal scotoma or incomplete arcuate or complete arcuate. So just it is an extension of the blind spot. Here the blind spot, and we have changes in this area. Here it is getting more toward the central, so it's arcuate but also encroaching on the paracentral area. Again, it's arcuate, but it's more and more encroaching on the rest of the field, reaching almost to altitudinal defect, but not complete up till now. Here we have arcuate scotoma reaching up to altitudinal. Here we have nasal step, because we have changes here and we have more changes there. So we have a step here, and down there we have inferior incomplete arcuate. This is the blind spot. So this area we accept it. When we have one or two isolated, we don't accept them. So we have here all these points touching one another, represent one area, but this is isolated two dots. We don't accept them as a change at the present stage. Now here the altitudinal, almost the whole hemisphere is included. Another example of altitudinal defect. Again, altitudinal defect. These three points touching one another, we take them into consideration. Again, almost complete altitudinal down and some arcuate up. So in this diagram, this is arcuate, this is altitudinal. Lastly, temporal wedge can be a sign of glaucomatous field changes. Keep in mind that names of the classic visual field defects are driven from the appearance of kinetic visual fields. An aesthetic perimetry, the same points are in a grid pattern, so the defects on the static visual field chart generally lacks the smooth contours suggested by such terms as arcuate. To be sure that the visual field defects is real, it should be confirmed in on repeated examinations. A change should be found on two repeated examinations after the initial one to accept that these changes are real changes. That's because the visual sensitivity varies from one test to the second. So we need to have a persistent changes over three times at least to be sure that these are a real change. In the Humphrey, the minimal criteria for diagnosis of glaucoma, one of these three: glaucoma hemifield test outside normal limit, pattern standard deviation changes with a probability of 5%, a cluster of three or more adjacent non-edge points in the pattern deviation plot, in a typical glaucomatous locations that did not cross the horizontal meridian, with probability 5%, and one of them must have a probability of 1%. As you know, the diagnosis of glaucoma does not depend on the field only. We have several things like the disc appearance, like the OCT changes and other things. But if you want to include the field, one of these three will help you to diagnose glaucoma. Keep in mind, we need a cluster of points to be sure that changes are real. But two points or one point has no value. The field of vision helps in diagnosis of glaucoma, but also it helps in staging the amount of damage. These are the American guidelines for stage of glaucoma. Early glaucomatous damage is characterized by having an optic disc anomaly, characteristic of glaucoma, with a normal field of vision. Moderate, again, we have characteristic disc anomaly and field of visions in one of the two hemispheres, but not inside the central 5 degrees. Severe glaucoma, if we have extensive field changes in both hemispheres or affection with the central 5 degrees. So all these stages, there is characteristic disc changes. You can see it by ophthalmoscope examination or an OCT. When field of vision is normal, this is early. When field of vision in one of the two hemispheres, this is moderate. When field is changes is in the two hemispheres or in the central 5 degrees, this is severe. So all have characteristic disc changes. Normal field means mild. Changes in one of the two hemispheres, this is moderate. Central area not included. Two hemispheres or central area included, this is severe. For the Canadian guidelines, they diagnose early glaucoma as field changes, mean deviation less than 6 decibels, cup disc ratio less than 0.65. Moderate glaucoma, significant field loss, but not inside the central 10 degrees, mean deviation between minus 6, minus 12, cup disc ratio 0.7 up to 0.85. Severe glaucoma, visual affection in the central 10 degrees, mean deviation worse than minus 12, cup disc ratio more than 0.9. So here, some changes in the field, this is early. Significant changes in the field, this is moderate. Affection in the central area, this is severe. Then depending on the mean deviation, below 6, this is early. Between 6 and 12, this is moderate. More than 12, this is severe. And also they included the cup disc ratio, less than or equal or more than 7 to 8.5 cup disc ratio. This is mild, moderate, severe. So in case of OCTOPUS, if you check the corrected comparison printout, you can say, yes, we have some changes here or extensive changes there. So we can say, yes, this is early, this is moderate, these dark spots are absolute scotoma, this is severe, just from the appearance. Again, the field of vision helps in detecting progression, and this is available in another presentation. So back to the word wonder. We started by what was done, accuracy, is it normal or abnormal, then defect patterns. Lastly, the E stands for evaluate compatible diseases. So we say this can be something in the retina, something in the nerve, something in the central area, something in glaucoma. Then evaluate such condition and review the literature for a better updated information. So I want to thank you for keeping to the end of this presentation. Have a nice day.